Finally, we're going to say, if two light waves pass through adjacent slits, then these semicircle waves can react with each other. Now, they can react in two different ways. We could say, when they come out, remember light travel can travel as a wave. We can say that they come out in a way where they line up perfectly with each other. So we're going to say that here the crests match up perfectly, the troughs or the bottom of the hills match up perfectly. And what is this going to do? This is actually going to make them combine together in a phenomenon known as constructive interference. So when the crests match up perfectly or the troughs match up perfectly of two waves, it's called constructive interference. And this is just going to basically double the height of the wave. So the height of the is going to create a new wave that is nearly twice as high because it's basically adding both waves together. So we're going to say constructive interference, since it's increasing the height by so much, the height of the wave, we're going to say that it increases our amplitude. Now, something else could happen. The two waves, instead of combining together, could wind up destroying one another. And this happens when they don't match up perfectly. Here, the crests don't match up perfectly. Here, it's a crest and a trough matching up. And these actually destroy one another. So for them to add up together, a crest and a crest must match up with a trough and a trough. But here, it's the opposite. A crest is matching, the high point of the wave is matching up with the low point of the wave, which is called the trough. This actually causes them to destroy each other. So instead of them adding up together, we're going to get no wave at all at the end, because both waves wind up destroying one another. We're going to say this is destructive interference. And since we destroy the wave, the amplitude gets destroyed too. So we're going to say there's going to be no amplitude anymore. The amplitude disappears because the wave disappears. So just remember, matter is just anything that possesses mass and takes up space. Mass and energy, although similar, they're different.